Well, good morning, 4C Christian School. It's Mrs. Visley, the principal. And today I'm joined by Mr. Scott, the assistant principal, and Mrs. Ford, our music teacher. And today our special speaker is Pastor Foster.
Hey guys, it's great to be with you.
Pastor Foster is a lead pastor at 4C Bible Church, but he's also a 4C Christian School parent.
Yes.
Three of Pastor Foster's children, three of his six children, are currently students at 4C Christian School. So we're really happy that he was able to take some time out this week and join us and talk to our students. I'm excited about that, and he will in just a few minutes. I just wanted to say a few things first. This is our last remote chapel of the school year. We hope that you've been encouraged spiritually through the chapel. We hope that you've been reminded about our theme this year, which was to live your faith. How appropriate living our faith through this really challenging time of being in quarantine and not even being able to be back in the building. Hopefully that's been a reminder to you. I know that the chapels have really, really encouraged me. This week we had our virtual state fair in the fourth grade. All fourth grade students participated in that. The state fair is a really special event that our fourth grade students do every year. They work all school year on it. They get assigned a state at the beginning of the year. They research that state. They actually reach out to people that live in the state, and they get items sent to them. And it's just a really fun, special event. And sadly, as many other things, we weren't able to do it in person in our school and our gym that we usually do. And Mr. Scott and I and all the teachers get to walk around and see the booths and talk to the students. We weren't able to do that, but we were able to have a virtual state fair this week. Yep. 63 students and parents showed up for that, and Mr. Scott and I too.
And my son was part of that, and wow, it was awesome. I just love the effort by our teachers and staff to pull those kinds of things off right now.
And Mrs. Ford, I saw her there. She was there for at least part of it as well. Mm-hmm. So Mr. Shapiro is one of our fourth grade teachers, and he champions the state fair. It's a big part of him and what he loves to do. And he actually has been around so long. My own two daughters, Callie and Jessie, wow. They were taught by Mr. Shapiro. They were part of the fourth grade state fair when they were at the school. So my own family's really been blessed by that and by him. So this is his last year. He's retiring after 20 years of teaching at 4C Christian School. So I would love it if you would want to send a little video recording to him, just thanking him for all his efforts and all he's done for our school and the state fair. There's some great pictures of that on our social media pages, video too, of some of the students' trifolds and their efforts on that. If you do send Mr. Shapiro a little tribute, I'd love to be copied on that email. I'd love to see those and hear those as well. So I have one more poem. I know I've been sharing poems the last few weeks. I've enjoyed finding poems online to share with you. So I have one more poem to share before we do our first song. And it's called When School Is Closing Soon by Janiel Wagstaff. When school is closing soon, my heart gets excited, but I'll miss my friends and teacher, so my feelings are divided. I think of all I've learned, like math, writing, and reading. I'm proud of my accomplishments and how I've been succeeding. So here's to summer months of fun, and to the next year too. I'll always remember this school year and how much I grew. Right. Hopefully you can relate to some of that. You're excited about school ending, but you're also a little divided because you're gonna miss your friends and your teacher. You'll have a new teacher next year or new teachers next year. Hopefully you can share in some of those. Hopefully you feel like you grew academically, but spiritually too, because this is 4C Christian School. So we do learn all the academics, but we also learn about how to grow in our faith and grow spiritually. So I'm hopeful that these chapels and the ones we used to have back in our building helped you with that this year, growing spiritually. So Mrs. Ford is going to lead us in a song.
All right. This is an oldie but a goodie, John 3:16. For God so loved the world.
Yeah.
that the Risers, Mrs. Ford?
You mean who was singing it?
Yeah, isn't that the Risers?
It actually doesn't say. I know that was the place that I first heard it was at Vacation Bible School.
Yeah.
So yeah, it doesn't.
The Risers, they're a lot of fun, a lot of fun. RIZERS. We've been singing their songs for a long time. A lot of fun.
Awesome. Mr. Scott.
Yes, yes, awesome. And that's one of my favorite scriptures, John 3:16. It's interesting because that's something that we say for see family in our morning affirmations. That's part of our morning affirmations. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, and whosoever believeth with him shall not perish but have everlasting life. And so again, I just want to encourage our students on today. We're almost at the end, so again, I want you guys to finish strong. Push. We're almost there. And this has been a growing experience for all of us, your teachers, myself, your parents. So give yourselves a pat on the back because you guys have been doing a great job. And so we've been seeing a lot of hard work that you guys have been putting in these last couple of months. So we encourage you just to keep going, keep moving, and we're almost at the finish line.
Well, first, second, and third graders were preparing for a spring concert, which would have been in the first week of June. And they loved the songs that we were working on. And even maybe some of the fifth graders remember this from a couple years ago. It was a musical that talked about loving God around the world. And so this song is called Dios Nos Ama. And it is one of our favorite songs in Spanish. Don't let anyone look down on you because you're young, but remember that God loves us. And you should tell everyone that you know that God loves us.
Hi, everyone.
Oh, of course. Of course. Now it's going to play a commercial. Hold on 1 second.
I'm here to share my story.
That's never happened. All right, here we go.
Don't let anyone look down on you because you're young. 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 Because
Awesome. That was excellent. Thank you so much, Mrs. Ford. That got me moving this morning. Hopefully it's getting you moving as well. Pastor Foster, take it away.
Yeah, wow. We were just in Jeremiah chapter 1 this morning with the kids, and that song, Don't Let Anyone Look Down on You Because You're Young, reminds me of what the Lord says to Jeremiah. He says, do not say I am too young. You must go to everyone I send you to and say whatever I command you. Do not say I am too young. So I just love that word. I just love that song. I just love our school. Wow. I just love the effort of our administration, of Mrs. Visley, Mr. Scott, of Mrs. Ford in these chapels, but of all of our teachers and staff. You guys are working so hard. Thank you so much. I love all the extra effort being done right now in this season and just the extra care that is being shown. So thank you. It's awesome. My kids are so blessed to be a part of this 4C Christian School family. And I am so honored to have this chance to share with you. You know, as a church, we've been in the book of Philippians. What a great book. If you're looking for something to read this summer, boys and girls, check out Philippians. Dig deep. It's all about joy. It's all about joy in the midst of hard. And I want to share just, there's a lot of great verses in Philippians, but probably the most beloved one, I just want to zero in on that today. And it's Philippians 4:13. And it says, repeat after me, I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. I can do everything through Christ who gives me strength. I can do everything through Christ who gives me strength. That's Paul writing. The person writing that verse, boys and girls, was in prison. He was going through a hard time. It was not an easy time. He was in a lockdown time. He was in a time when he could have a lot of questions about what God was doing and why was God doing it, and it felt hard. And right away, it just reminds me that, you know, we're all going to go through some hard. This season is kind of hard. I hope you're, you know, seeing God's blessing in it, but it's okay if it feels hard. It's okay if it doesn't feel right. It's okay if you miss seeing me every day on your way into school. I know all you're missing that a real lot. I miss seeing you, I will say that, but it's okay if it's hard. You know what? Followers of Jesus have done hard for a long time, all right? Previous generations of boys and girls, of men and women, have done hard for a long time. In fact, I think every generation goes through its hard. And during that time, it's a time when we seek and find Jesus. And so the times that are hard can be the times with the most hope, because it drives us to look to God and to look to Jesus like never before. And that's kind of what was happening with Paul. Is, you know, he was going through his hard. He was in prison. It was not easy. But he's finding joy in Christ, and he's writing, I can do everything through Christ who gives me strength. I just want to think about that verse. I just want to break it down with you. Let's start with the first two words. I can. I can. I can. You know, you can do this through Christ. This hard, you can do through Christ. It's not just something that your parents can do. It's not just something your 4C Christian School teachers can do. It's not just something that other students can do. You sometimes we feel like, I don't really know God well enough to deal with things like this. I see other people seeking Jesus. I don't really know how to. Listen, Paul says, I can. I can. Now, Paul, wow. You know, he was a guy that didn't follow Jesus for a long time. Remember, he was the exact opposite of a Jesus follower. He hated and tried to make things very hard for the people that were following Jesus. And then God got a hold of his heart, and God changed his life, and he began to follow Jesus. And if Paul could do everything through Christ, even with a man that he had been so far away from God, guess what, boys and girls? You can. You can do your hard. You can get through this through Christ. You can say, I can't, I can do this. I can. You can. You know, and part of it is because God so loved the world, he gave his only son. We just sang that whoever believes in him will not perish but have eternal life. It doesn't matter where you've been in the course of your thoughts about God, your feelings about God, your relationship with God. He loves you. He died for you. He rose for you. He invites you to call on him to save you, to forgive you your sin, to give you eternal life. And you can do that, and you can have Christ in your life, and you can cling to Christ now, no matter what you've done, you know, up until now or even recently. You can. You can do everything. You can do everything. Do you understand that? Like, there's nothing that doesn't fit into the category of what you can do. This coronavirus, this lockdown, this hard, this school from, you know, far away, this using computers to talk to your teachers, this trying to work through your assignments, this summer without swimming or without whatever else you're missing out on, without sport, that is part of the everything that you can do. You can do this. Everything you can do. Do you think when God wrote this, do you think when Paul wrote this in Philippians, do you think that he knew this time was coming for boys and girls around the world today? Yes, he did. And he still said, you can do everything through Christ who gives you strength. Wow. Just know that this is not beyond what God can do and what he can enable you to do. You can do everything through Christ. That's the catch. We can't do this on our own. We're not supposed to. In fact, when other generations have gone through hard, it's made them look to Jesus. It's made them come to an end of themselves and say, I can't do this on my own. I don't have what it takes on my own. I don't have what it takes apart from Christ. But you can do everything through him, through Christ. That's why Paul says earlier here, I want to know Christ and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of sharing in his suffering. Paul says, bring it all on. Bring the glory. Bring the heart. If it helps me to know Christ, then I'm going to do it through Christ. It's just a reminder. We've got to stop and not just, you know, do homework and watch shows and you know, pick on our brothers and sisters. I mean, love our brothers and sisters. We got to talk to Jesus. And I hope, boys and girls, that you're having some conversations with Jesus. And just know that you don't need to be at 4C Christian School or at 4C Bible Church or at your church building to talk to Jesus. That Jesus can meet you anywhere and everywhere, and he loves it when we just talk to him. My daughter, Fenn, was baptized this past Saturday, and wow, she is now 14 years, wow, she's 15 years old. She just turned 15. She came to us from China when she was 11. Just recently, we were having Bible time in the morning, and I said, kids, just go and get in the Word, and I gave them some verses to read, and have your own time of talking to Jesus. And for her, it was like, just a reminder, like, wait, I can talk to Jesus, Dad. I don't need to sit with you at the table to talk to Jesus. I can actually talk to Jesus. And next thing you know, she gets a pillow out, puts it on the ground, kneels on it, and just starts talking to Jesus. Says, dear Jesus, thank you that I can talk to you. Dear Jesus, this is hard, but thank you that I can talk to you. And she's just openly talking to Jesus. And God loves that, because we can do everything, but it has to be through Christ. Talk to Jesus. Read his word. You know, read those verses this summer that you've memorized this year, that you've been focused on at school this year. Because you can do everything through Christ who gives. That's a reminder. He gives you strength. It's a gift that he wants to give you. You can't get it from inside yourselves. You can't just say, I'm going to be stronger. I'm going to do this. I'm going to be better. I can get through this. It's a gift from outside of you. It means we have to go to Jesus and say every day, please, God, give me strength today. Give me strength today. Talk to Jesus. Give me strength today. You can do everything through Christ who gives you strength. Strength. There's power available. We feel so powerless. We feel like I can't do the things I want to do. I can't see the people I want to see. I can't go the places I want to go. No, there's strength that we have. There's power that we have. It's not just things that have been taken away from us. God wants to give us new strength and new power and new hope and new joy and new life in this time through Jesus. Boys and girls, I get it. This is hard. This is kind of your hard. This is the hard that you're going to be talking about for a long time. It might get harder before it gets easier. I don't know. But you know what you're also going to be talking about? You're going to be talking about, just like people for generations before you, how Jesus showed up in the midst of hard, how you came to depend on Jesus, to talk to Jesus more than ever, to love Jesus more than ever, to need Jesus more than ever. You're going to talk about how Jesus did an amazing work in this hard, weird, horrible season in so many ways. God came and did some of his best work because you can do everything through Christ who gives you strength. Oh Lord God, may it be true for our students. May this be their story. May this be what they say. May they stand on this verse and this promise that they can do everything through Christ who gives them strength. Lord, may you do it in them and through them. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you.
Wow, thank you so much, Pastor Foster. That really encouraged me. I'm ready to go too. I'm ready to go back and talk to Jesus some more today. So thank you. Thank you everyone for joining us for chapel today. And we'll say bye now. Bye.
Bye-bye.